Hey everybody, it's a beautiful Wednesday, September the 29th. It's National Coffee Day, and it's time for the Wize Guys and Girl and Matt and Grace, sponsored by the Zeller's Restaurant, where their motto is, if it doesn't exist, we can't cook it. As always, let's start with Sir and the weather.
Well, a wonderful Wednesday indeed. Currently 16 degrees, working our way up to a high of 19 under sunny skies today, tomorrow, and into Friday. And for today's random daily shout-out, I'd like to give this daily shout-out to the quaint little coffee shop that I discovered on my way into work this morning. Weird, though, I walked in for the very first time, but felt that I had already been there. Must have been a case of déjà brew.
Oh, nice, that's her. Well, today we observe National Coffee Day. You know, even those who don't drink coffee tend to enjoy the fragrance that roasted beans cast. There's a mother, I gotta make sure I pronounce this right, Mother Parker's, just up on Haynes Boulevard, and if the wind is just right, that smell. And yes, of course, yesterday I made the legendary move of making coffee in the Keurig without putting a mug underneath. Yeah.
Splash of coffee, sir.
And then this morning I was sitting drinking coffee in my slippers. I really need to wash some mugs. I did get sorted out with my Tell Me a Story mug. Let's see it, Grace. There it is. But I spilled coffee on my keyboard. I thought I'd have big problems. Fortunately, my keyboard still works fine. The spill was under control. All right, we are absolutely so excited to have Grace join us today. Grace Aki, a Georgia peach turned New York City pizza rat, star of the one-woman play To Free a Mockingbird, and host of Tell Me on a Sunday podcast. And when she's not doing that, she feeds her cat, which I'm sure the cat never lets you forget to do that.
Not dead yet.
No. Anyway, it is time for Grounds with Grace. Grace, what have you got for us today?
Good morning, y'all. It is National Coffee Day, and I have to tell you, famously, I cannot ingest coffee. For some reason, it doesn't agree with my body, and the grounds make me nauseous. So here we are drinking tea. I literally ordered this last night in preparation for the show today. It's an Earl Grey with a milk cap, which if you're unfamiliar with how bubble tea works for a lot of like Asian culture people out there, it's a salty, sweet milk cap that sits on top of the tea, and it kind of like permeates throughout. So that's my little coffee moment of the day, is to say, hey, sometimes you can fool people into ordering a tea and then you put it in a coffee mug and people think you're cool, which is what I do every single day.
All right. Perfect tasty beverage. See, we're always learning here on the Wize Guys and Girl. People think that because we're wise, we know a lot of things, but, you know, fake it till you make it.
Okay. Nobody believes that.
Love to make to tell us the truth.
Keeps you grounded.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
right. Grounded.
We hear from Rohini. Well done, miss. All right. Well, it is time for Tunes with Tamik. Tamik, what are we listening to today? I wasn't sure which way you'd go. I thought you might go with Beyonce's All the Single Lattes, or maybe something by Tupac Shakur.
No, I definitely cannot do it. Could I do a Tupac song? Maybe one. Not many Tupac songs I can do on the show.
Grounds Paradise.
That, yes, that's possible.
Wow.
But today, yes. Today I'm going with a South African producer / DJ by the name of Black Coffee. Amazing, amazing producer and DJ. And he has a song called Happiness. And I thought, you know, it's been a tough couple days already, and it's only Wednesday. So I said, let's give her a lift. So it goes, the beginning, and you know, it always gets me at the beginning. Sometimes in life, we have to go through such phases. Sometimes in life, we have to struggle for some reason. If you believe, you can achieve with time. Just hold on and be strong. You will receive happiness. Like, beautiful, right? So, really great song, really great rhythmic song to get you through the day. And just, yeah, even if you go on a little bit further, says you gotta hold on to your dream, You've got to be strong. Keep your head up. You got to hold on because you can achieve. So this is for all the 4 or maybe 14. We never know how many people are really listening. People that are out there that are having a tough week sometimes. And we've all had a tough couple years. Just listen to the song Happiness today by Black Coffee. Keep your head up. And hopefully that will give you a little bit of joy today. So that is my pick, Happiness by Black Coffee.
Awesome. Great choice.
Can I add an honorable mention? I think we can add Toast by Coffee from Jamaica. That's a good song as well.
Ooh.
Yeah, Toast is amazing.
Gosh.
Would you like to bless us with some of the lyrics to Toast?
Unfortunately, no.
Oh, gosh.
I thought that's where you were going, right? With singing, but no.
Maybe next time. All right. Well, that means it's time for Ventures with Venturo. Venturo, what have you got for us today?
You know what? I just gave myself another assignment. So I went looking for books for coffee enthusiasts, and I found a couple. So I'm going to suggest one for you guys. So go read it. I have not read it, but from my research, it is suggesting that it's a very good read. It's called God in a Cup by Mikhail Wiseman. So go check out that book, and I'll just add it to my assignments to give you the full review probably a couple months from now. That's it for Ventures with Venturo.
Maybe on Tuesdays we'll get the book review from the previous week, Venturo, to set us up for the next week.
Oh my god.
Well, welcome to this week's edition of The Sizzler, where our own Vice Principal Botnick and our special guest, Matt Schulman, Quote Machine, work together to earn our gift certificate to the Zeller's Restaurant. Matt, how are you doing today?
Words cannot espresso how I'm doing.
I heard a rumor, I'd like you to confirm or deny, that you once lost a job in a coffee shop because you kept wearing a t-shirt.
It was grounds for dismissal.
Well, today you will earn valuable Zeller's Restaurant dollars based on the accuracy and creativity of your responses and how much they delight the wise guys and girl and Grace. Remember that one bonus dollar is earned each time you get Venturo to laugh out loud, and we're already starting with $3 in the kitty from Monday's and Tuesday's fun. In my hand, I have a list of questions about coffee brought to you by Wawa. The city's so nice, they named it twice. And Wawa is celebrating National Coffee Day by offering all customers free coffee all day. So head on up. It's just 2 hours north of Sault Ste. Marie. May not make it today. All right. Question one. How long does caffeine from coffee stay in your body? Vice Principal Botnick.
In my case, approximately 60 seconds. Fast, all coffee, this liquid in, out.
This explains your office placement. I get it now. $3 for the geographical reference. Matt Schulman.
At 6 cups a day, the caffeine never leaves my body.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, $6. That's excellent. That's a lot of caffeine. Good golly gee whiz. Question number two. Where did Chock Full of Nuts coffee get its name? Matt Schulman.
It's a bit of a long story, but I'll speed it up. When the squirrel fell into the bean grinder and actually enhanced the flavor, the company knew it was onto something. But since you can't associate coffee with ground rodents, they had to think of something. Luckily, the first squirrel had its cheek full of almonds, and thus a brand was born.
Wow, that's $4 for a shaggy squirrel story. Well done, sir. Vice Principal Botnick.
Well, in some interesting research that I just made up, taking a page from your research methodology, I discovered that the creator of Chock Full of Nuts used to own a hardware store in New York City. It's one of his employees that just broken his favorite coffee mug and served a fresh brewed cup of coffee the first thing that he found, which was, you guessed it, a tin full of nuts. Bit of a heavy brew with a hint of iron. To make a long story short, the toxic brew killed the owner. The employee claimed it was an accident, took over the business, and transformed the store into a coffee shop. And did you know that now, 76 years later, you can still enjoy a cup of chock-full of nuts coffee and made with only 10% real hardware?
How did you come up with that?
Again, it was the research that I made up from.
That was 10%. So that's a bonus. Thank you very much, sir. And question three. If you consult an expert cupper, what would they advise you about? Matt Shulman.
Not to put your nose too close to your coffee. That skin burns easily.
Yeah, two nostrils, $2. Vice Principal Botnick.
I didn't want to touch this one, but athletic supports?
I always understood you to be a great athletic supporter, sir. I think there's another $2 in there. 2, 4, 6, 10, hey, $22 at the Zealous Restaurant this week. And with our new guest, Grace, that's lunch for everybody and dessert. Well done, everybody. Great job, gentlemen. Okay, that brings us to Wednesday, and it's time for Wednesday's word.
Let's do it. Okay, so today's word is manipulate. This is when you skillfully influence someone to drink coffee, something that I did not do well earlier. But I will say, if anybody's going to manipulate me, it's this ad I got this morning from Krispy Kreme Donuts telling me that it's National Coffee Day with a free donut of choice. So,
all right, let's go.
Times Square has a 24-hour one. Everybody's welcome to join me.
All right.
You mean these days are real? I thought you made them all up. Blows my mind.
Answer for your sins.
Learn something new every day. All right, well, that is it for us, everybody. Thanks to our fans and friends and odds and ends for sticking with us. Thanks especially to Grace for joining us today. Thanks, Grace. It was awesome to have you. Hey, everybody, if you like our show, make sure you subscribe, leave a comment, and tell your friends to listen. If you don't like our show, tell your friends anyway and let them make up their own minds. Have a great Wednesday. We are the Wize Guys and Girl and Matt and Grace, leaving you smarter and happier than you were yesterday.